I was asked the question, why are certain passenger cars called heavyweights? To answer that question, we need to look backwards and do some comparisons and track a little bit the history of the passenger car. When passenger trains first came about, they were nothing more than stagecoaches put on wheels. And over time, these coaches were transformed into passenger cars that are made of all wood. These passenger cars carried straight bench seats typically. They oftentimes had some sort of a small fireplace at one end or at both ends, and some of them even had a bathroom in them. And this was the perceived method of travel that, you know, was sought after because railroads truly were the roadways of that day and age. People didn't have vehicles other than horses and carriages, and roads were in dismal shape if they existed at all. So rail was the way to go. Railroads did not make a lot of money off of passenger trains. They preferred to haul freight, and so the passenger trains just weren't the priority. As trains, especially in the 60s, 1860s, 1870s, 1880s, trains got heavier, they got longer, they got faster, the locomotives got more powerful, and as the speed increased, the accidents increased as well, because at that point, the infrastructure for signaling trains accurately was not very well established. And one terrible consequence of this progression were passenger trains. And an awful thing tended to happen if a passenger train was involved in an accident. And this was called telescoping. With telescoping, a car would actually slide into the car in front of it, and the car behind that would slide into the car in front of it, and so on and so forth. And so you had this collapsing of one car into the next, into the next, into the next, obviously maiming or killing all the people involved. And the other thing that was so terrifying about these instances is that those small stoves would, in this tinderbox of splintered wood and mangled bodies. And so following these awful train wrecks, there'd usually be a fire. And so people oftentimes didn't escape with their lives. It was just a terrible, terrible tragedy if a passenger train wrecked. So after some outcry, the railroads begrudgingly made the investment to transition from all wood coaches to steel coaches. And once this happened, these coaches tended to be long enough, 70 to 80 feet, and once you added the steel component, they typically required six-wheel trucks, and they were very, very heavy. And this generation of railroad cars came to be known as heavyweights, because they were indeed that, very heavy. The good thing about these types of cars is they did protect their occupants in case of an accident. So that safety feature was very important, and they proved their mettle, so to speak, in when it came to accidents. Again, as we look towards the progression of railroads, fast forward in railroad history to the late 1920s to the mid 1930s, the latest rage at that time for railroad management was something called streamlining. They were trying to capture the imagination of the public, and they were doing this out of probably fear to some degree, because the airplane had come into its own infancy. And so they were borrowing some of that streamlining that you saw in the early DC-3 type airplanes, and trying to apply that idea to their locomotives and rail cars. And so you may have seen cowlings that fit over steam engines, turning them into this very smooth-fronted and smooth-sided monster of a machine. And some of the early diesels, of course, were streamlined as well, having very smooth and aerodynamic fronts. And then oftentimes with these cowlings and streamlined diesels, there were new train sets. or passenger sets that would go with these. The new passenger sets oftentimes included stainless steel sides and were typically had more aluminum to them and less weight, and they were called streamliners. And these streamliner sets were again touted as being, you know, the most modern, the most advanced, and this was by and large the third generation of passenger cars. And really, passenger cars haven't changed a lot since then. Now we see, you know, now interurban passenger sets that probably have a little bit more aluminum in them and are certainly more lightweight than the first streamliner cars would be. But there hasn't been a lot of progression, and part of that is just because rail is no longer seen as a major point of travel here in the United States. Now, across, as you know, in Japan and China and Europe, where they have their high-speed transportation, that's a different story altogether. So, John, thanks again for asking the question, what a heavyweight is. I hope this has been helpful. And as always, I appreciate your comments and feedback below. Thanks again for tuning in to Austin's American Flyer YouTube page. Enjoy your trains.